Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to my today's class. So, as in the last class, I started the fifth chapter of your syllabus, that is Principle of Inheritance and Variations. In previous class, we have started this topic. And the points which we have covered in the previous class are what is meant by genetics and what are the definitions of inheritance and variations. We have cleared all the points. And then we have seen some of the important terminologies which is used in the genetics. And then after that we have seen the Mendel's propositions. So already you know that who is the Mendel? Mendel is the scientist who is called as the father of genetics. He has proposed the law of inheritance. And then next point what we have seen in the previous class is the law of dominance. In that we have seen the inheritance of one gene and inheritance of the two genes. Okay. So what is mean by inheritance of one gene? That is nothing but the monohybrid cross. So in the simple language, what is mean by inheritance? The inheritance is nothing but the heredity. So the characters which have passes from parents to the offsprings of the next generation, that is called as what? Inheritance. And what is variation? Variation means the characters which does not passes from the parents but it is formed in the offsprings, that is called as the variations. So the inheritance of one gene, which is also called as the monohybrid cross, and then in that what we have seen the inheritance of one gene. In that, to explain about the inheritance of one gene, the Mendel has selected a pea plant as his experimental plant, and in that he has taken that plant differing in only one contrasting character, that is height of the plant. So as you know that one parent he selected the tall plant, another parent he selected the dwarf plant. So he has crossed this tall and the dwarf plants, and which the genotypes of this is what? The tall genotype is capital T capital T and dwarf genotype is the small t small t. Then the gametes are formed from the tall plant as the capital T and the dwarf plant is the small t. So when we cross these two parents, what the offsprings are produced in the F1 generation, that is the heterozygous tall plant. So capital T and small t is produced, that is called as the tall plant, but it is not a homozygous, it is a heterozygous. So why this capital T and small t is the tall plant? Because the capital T is dominant over the recessive gene. Okay, so already law of dominance, what it states, whenever a pair of contrasting characters are together, one of the allele is what? The dominant, which is dominates over the another allele, that is called as the recessive. So the what the offsprings are produced in the F1 generation, all the tall plants are produced, but they are the heterozygous. So what is the next step of this is what? Selfing F1. So whenever we cross the whatever the F1 generation is produced, self-crossed, then what? In F2 generation, the gametes are produced. Then the F2 generation will be represented by the Punnett square pole. So what the ratio of this monohybrid cross is produced, the phenotype and the genotype ratio. So as you know that the phenotype means the external appearance, okay, and morphological appearance. And genotype means what? The genetic makeup of an individual. So the ratio which is produced, the phenotype ratio of this monohybrid cross is what? 3:1. What is 3? Tall plants. 1 is what? Dwarf plant. Similarly, the genotype ratio of this monohybrid cross is 1:2:1. Okay, what is 1? First one is the monohybrid cross, the 1 is tall plant, that is homozygous tall plant. Then 2 is the heterozygous tall plant and 1 is the homozygous dwarf plant. So this is about the monohybrid cross. And then we have seen the monohybrid cross is nothing but the inheritance of one gene. So the next point we have seen that the inheritance of two genes. Okay. So in this experiment, the Mendel has selected the pea plant which is differing in the two characters. So as he has selected the seeds. Okay. The shape of the seed and the color of seed. So the color of seed is what? Yellow and green he selected. And then the color of shape of the seed is the round and wrinkled. So he has selected these two characters differing in a single plant, that is pea plant. And then he again the same crossing, whatever the procedure is there to solve the genetic problem is the same. But what the difference is there? In inheritance of one gene, only one character is deferred, and inheritance of two gene, the two characters are deferred. Okay, and then here, what is the ratio which is produced in the F2 generation of the dihybrid cross? That is 9:3:3:1. And then, so this is about the inheritance of 2G, that is nothing but dihybrid cross. So this monohybrid and the dihybrid cross comes under the law of dominance. Law of dominance means whenever the two alleles are together, one allele is dominant, another is the recessive. Okay, and dominant allele suppresses the recessive allele. Okay, means here the recessive allele fails to express its character. So this is called as the law of dominance. So in today's class, we have to see about the incomplete dominance. Okay, incomplete dominance. So what is that incomplete dominance? We'll see. Incomplete dominance. So what is mean by incomplete dominance? When the two alleles are together in a heterozygous condition, one of the dominant allele fails to suppress the recessive allele. As a result, both the allele together expresses intermediate character, is called as the incomplete dominance. The definition of this, I'll write on the board, you also note down. Okay? What is the definition? When the two heterozygous alleles are together, one of the dominant allele fails to suppress recessive allele completely. As a result, both the alleles together expresses intermediate character is called as incomplete dominance. Okay, in the law of dominance, what we are seeing is that the dominant allele, whatever one of the dominant allele is there, which is suppresses to the recessive allele and it expresses its character. But here in incomplete dominance, what happens when the two heterozygous alleles are together? Okay, when the two heterozygous means one is dominant and one is the recessive, when they both are together, one of the dominant allele, okay, the allele which is dominant, which it fails to suppress the recessive allele, means here the dominant allele cannot express its character and it fails to suppress the recessive allele. At that time, what happens? As a result, both the alleles together, means dominant as well as the recessive alleles together, expresses the intermediate character and it is called as the incomplete dominance. Okay, I'll repeat once again the definition. It is very important for the examination. In examination, it will be asked for the 5 marks question. In the year 2019, the question is asked in annual examination, explain incomplete dominance. Okay, for 5 marks. So first of all, you have to write the definition. What is the definition? When the two heterozygous alleles are together, one of the dominant allele fails to suppress recessive allele completely. As a result, both the allele together expresses intermediate characters. Okay. So to explain this in the incomplete dominance, what the example they are selected? First is the flower color. Okay. Flower color in snapdragon. One example is flower color in snapdragon. Okay. The another example is, this is the one. Antirrhinum species. Which is called as dog flower, which is also called as a dog flower. The another example is 4 o'clock plant. Okay, generally we call this plant is a 4 o'clock plant, and the scientific name of this 4 o'clock is Mirabilis gelata. Mirabilis. Okay. So see, to explain the incomplete dominance, what the example is selected? These are the four different plants species in which he has noticed the character is what? The color, flower color in these plants. Okay. So first of all, the example is what? The flower color in the snapdragon flower plant, and then the Antirrhinum species. Okay. This is the plant Antirrhinum species in which the example is what? The dog flower. Okay. Then next one is the 4 o'clock plant. Generally in our local language we can call this plant is a 4 o'clock plant, and then the scientific name of this is what? Mirabilis gelata. So this is about what the plant is selected and what is the definition of incomplete dominance. And next we have to see how this, whatever the characters he selected, what are the genotypes he has selected, how the crossing of these two different plant has been taken place. Okay. So to study about the incomplete dominance, we have to notice the color of the flower. So we have what the example here selected. I told you the name of example of these plants. So in which the example he has taken a parental plant as this plant, which is differing in what? Only a color of the flower. So first one is he has selected one plant with the flower of the red color flowers. Okay. Red color flowered plant. One is the red color flowered plant. Another one is the white color flowered plant. So these two plants he has selected as a experimental plant, which is differing in the color of the flower. One is the red and another one is the white. So now we have to see what is the genotype he has used for the red color and what is the genotype for the white color. Okay. So for red color, the genotype is what? Capital R, capital R. For white color, the genotypes are small r, small. Okay. So already you know that monohybrid cross also you have seen that tall line dot, what the genotypes he has taken, capital T, small t, small t. Similarly here also the red color flower plant and white color flower plant, capital R, small r, small r. So these are the two parental plant generation. And what are the next steps to solve this genetic problem of the incomplete dominance? We have to see stepwise. First one is, what are the steps? Incomplete dominance. first one is, first step is the parent. Okay, what are the parents? Homozygous red flower. This parent generation homozygous red flower. Homozygous white flower. Okay, so this red and white is the phenotype. Now, what is the genotype we have to see? The genotypes are, for the red flower, I told you, we have to take here capital R, capital R, and for white flower, we have to take here small r, small r. Okay? Next step is gamete formation. So, as these are the homozygous gametes. So, gametes of this one parent is from this two capital R, because here these are the homozygous, both are the same. You have to take here only a single R. This is the gamete of one parent. Here also small r. So this is the parent of, sorry, this is the gamete of another parent. Okay. Now here we have to see, we have to cross these two plants and what the hybrids are produced in the F1 generation. F1 generation, capital R, small r. Okay. So now here, from this onwards, something will change in this incomplete dominance. Because, see, in the monohybrid cross, whenever here the capital T, small t came, what we have written here? Tall plant. Okay. Which in which what? Heterozygous tall plant. But here what the difference is, this is the incomplete dominance. So here, this capital R, okay, which is dominant, it fails to express its character. This both can be fails to express its character and they form the intermediate character. We are seeing in the definition. So, what color of flowers are formed in the F1 generation is, the pink colored flowers are formed. Pink color flower. So, as you can see here, the red flower are crossed with the white color flower. Instead of forming red or the pink color, sorry, red or the white color, the pink colored flowers are formed. Why it is? Because it is the incomplete dominance. Means here, both these parents are, this both the dominant as well as recessive alleles are fails to express their characters. And both, they both together forms the intermediate character, which is called as what here? The pink colored flowers are formed in the F1 generation. So this is the main important difference in the law of dominance as well as in the incomplete dominance you have to remember. So many of the students makes the mistakes, okay, while solving this genetic problem. Instead of writing the pink color flower, they will write what? Red color flower. But it is wrong. You just remember that this both the alleles together forms the intermediate character. Here, the pink colored flowers are formed. What is the next step? Selfie F1. When? Selfie F1 hybrid. F1 hybrid. So, same here, what the F1 hybrids are formed? Capital R, small r into capital R, small r. Okay? So, what the gametes are formed and what we have to see? The F2 generation by Poonen square board. Okay? F2 generation by Poonen square. Okay. So when I am solving these problems in your notebook with me, along with me, you also have to solve in the book. By that, the points will get clear. Okay? So this is your Punnett square board. Here are the two parents. One is the male, another one is the female. And what the gametes are formed in the F2 generation? Here, capital R. Here, small r. Capital R, small r. Okay? Now we have to cross this. Okay? Gametes. Here, first of all, very simple. Already you have studied the two problems, monohybrid and dihybrid cross. So first, capital R, capital R. Capital R into capital R, capital R, capital R. Then capital R, small r. Then capital R, this R. Okay. First we have to write the, while writing we have to use to write the capital letter first. Then lastly, small r, small r. Now we have to recognize which the flowers are red, pink and the white color. So you can see here this capital R is the completely homozygous. What is meant by this capital R? Red color flower. Okay. These are the red flower. And then capital R, small r. Here also capital R, small r. So what is this capital R, small r? These are the pink colored flower, not a red color. Okay. Pink. And here also pink color flower. And lastly, smaller, smaller. Already you know that. What is meant by smaller, smaller? White color flower. So this is the F2 generation. It is the same as what? The crossing is same as the monohybrid. But what the difference is? You have to remember from the F1 generation. It is the differences are there. Okay. So now we have to see the next step is phenotype and the genotype ratio. So in incomplete dominance, the phenotype and the genotype ratio is similar. Okay. What we'll see here? First I will write phenotype ratio. So phenotype ratio is, we have to see how many are red color, only one. How many are pink color? 2. And how many are white color? 1. So what is the ratio? 1:2:1. So what is the 1 here? You can see in this here, 1 is the red flower and 2 are the pink flowers and 1 is the white colored flower. Now we have to see the genotype ratio. Genotype ratio. Here also it is the same. We can see what the genotypes are there. Capital R, capital R. You can see here somewhere it is there. No. So how many are there? Only one is there. So right here 1. Okay, 1:2. Capital R, small r. How many are there? 1 and 2 are there. So this is 1 and this is 2. Okay. So 1:2. And lastly, small r, small r. How many are there? Only 1. So now here 1:2:1, 1 is what? Capital R, capital R, 2 is capital R, small r, and 1 is the small r, small r. So this is the genotype ratio. You can look at this is what? The phenotype and the genotype ratio is similar. 1:2:1, 1:2:1. So by this observing, you can see that this is what completely like a monohybrid cross. Okay. So same it is like a monohybrid cross, but what the difference is there? There, the tall plants only formed. Means the two parents, what they have the characters, one character is formed in F1 generation. But here what happens? These two parents together forms the intermediate character. Once again, I will revise this incomplete dominance from starting to end. First of all, to explain this incomplete dominance, the plant is selected, which is differing in a flower color. Okay. Already I told you the name of the plants, that is snapdragon, Anderian species. Three examples I told you, okay, 4 o'clock plant. So first of all, he has selected one parental plant, his parental generation as the homozygous red colored flower plant and the homozygous white colored flower plant. Okay. Then what the genotypes are taken? For the red color, capital R, capital R. For white color, small r, small r. So what the gametes are formed from this genotype is capital R from one parent and small r from the another parent. So F1 generation hybrids are capital here, instead of red or the white colored flower, the pink colored flowers are formed in the F1 generation. Next, when selfing F1 hybrids, what the gametes are formed? These are the gametes. From one parent, capital R smaller, from another parent, capital R smaller. So, in the F2 generation, which is represented by the donated square, in which what the plants are formed, the plants with the flower color, red color, pink color and the white color. Three different types of the hybrids are formed in the F2 generation. So, what are the ratio of this phenotype and the genotype? The ratio is the same in incomplete dominance, both the phenotype as well as the genotype. What is that ratio? 1:2:1. So, in phenotype ratio, 1 is the red colored flower, 2 is the pink colored flower and 1 is the white colored flower. Next is genotype ratio. Genotype ratio is the same as phenotype ratio, 1:2:1. So, what is this 1? Capital R, capital R, genotypes. This 2 is capital R, smaller and 1 is the smaller, smaller. So, this is about the incomplete dominance. Okay. You remember that the main practice of this solving the genetic problem, because from these three problems, that is monohybrid, dihybrid and incomplete dominance, anyone will be asked for the 5 marks question in your examination. So you have to make practice of this diagram, you make practice of this solving the problems. So how the question will come based on this point? What is incomplete dominance? Explain, or explain incomplete dominance. So, by taking this example of this flower color, and then you have to solve this problem from starting to end here. Okay. So, this is about incomplete dominance. So, the next point we have to see about the co-dominance. First, we have seen law of dominance, incomplete dominance, and the next point we have to see co-dominance. Okay. Okay, now we have to see co-dominance. Co-dominance. Firstly, we have seen the law of dominance, then incomplete dominance, and now we have to see co-dominance. Okay, so what is mean by co-dominance? I will write the definition here first. You also note down the definition. When the alleles for two contrasting characters are together in heterozygous condition. So what is the definition? When the alleles for two contrasting characters are together in heterozygous condition, both the allele expresses its character is called as co-dominant. So as we have seen in the law of dominance, only one allele expresses its character, and in the incomplete dominance, both the allele fails to express their character, but in co-dominance, what? Both the allele expresses its character. Okay. So this is called as the co-dominance. A good example for this co-dominance, to understand the co-dominance, is ABO blood group in human. ABO blood group in human. So this is a good example to understand the codominance concept. Okay, and here another thing is in codominance, you can see the example, we can see that here the multiple allele also. Multiple allele. So what is mean by multiple allele? We'll see here. It is a phenomenon of expression in expression by a single gene. By a single gene in more than two alternative forms occupying same locus on homologous chromosomes and controlling a single character. Okay, so see, what is codominance? We have seen the example is ABO blood group. What is the definition? When the alleles for two contrasting characters are together in heterozygous condition, both the allele expresses its character together. Okay, so example is ABO blood group. So to understand this codominance, we have to see the multiple allele. What is mean by the multiple allele definition? It is a phenomenon of expression by a single gene in more than two alternative forms occupying same locus on homologous chromosomes and controlling a single character is called as the multiple allele. So now here, to understand this codominance, we have to see the example is ABO blood group. How it is, we'll see now. Controlled by a single gene and which is called as the I. Okay, the first point is blood group in human controlled by gene capital I. Okay. So, what is mean by I? Where here I refers to isoagglutinogene. Gene. Okay. So first step is, first point is what? The blood group in human is controlled by gene I. What is mean by I here? I refers to isoagglutinogene. Okay. Next is the gene I has allele IA, IB and small I. Okay. So next point is this IA and IB is completely dominant over small I. Capital IA, capital IB, okay, completely dominant over small I. Okay, next is this capital I and small I capital I A and capital I B, they both are the codominant. Codominant. Hence, the gene I has the three different alleles, that is IA, IB and small I. So now we have to see what are the genotypes of ABO blood group. Genotypes of ABO blood group. Blood group is 6. Okay. We find here the 6 different types of the genotype of ABO blood group. What are that? We have to see. What is next heading? Genotype of ABO blood group. So what is the blood group? First we will see A. I will make the box for this. Easily you can understand. Okay, first we will take blood group A. So what is the genotype for this is capital IA, capital IA. Okay, then this is the homozygous. Another one is for A is heterozygous. Allele is capital IA, small I. This is why this is A blood group, because this capital IA dominates over the small I. Next, B, blood group B. So here IB, I. Okay. Then one more genotype. This is the homozygous B blood group. Next one is a heterozygous B blood group. For this genotype is capital I B and small I. Okay, so this is A blood group, B blood group. One more is what? AB. AB blood group, for this capital IA, capital IB. And the last is the universal donor, that is blood group is O. So for this genotype is small and small. So this is the genotype. 6 different genotypes of the 4 blood groups, that is 4 different blood groups in the human. You can see this is the A blood group, B, AB and O. So A here, for A and B, 2 are there. One is the homozygous condition, that is genotype is IA, IB. And heterozygous condition, IA, small I. So B, for B blood group, capital IB, IB. For heterozygous B blood group, capital IB, small I. Then AB blood group, capital IA, capital IB. And for O blood group, small I, small I. So this is the genotype of ABO blood group of man. The question may be asked for 2 marks in examination. Write the 6 genotypes of ABO blood group. Okay, so you have to remember these 4 types of the blood groups along with the genotypes. Okay, next one more we'll see. When the 2 parents are together, okay, suppose if one parent has a blood group A, another parent has blood group B, and what the genotypes will come in the offsprings, that we have to see. Okay, how it will come, again we'll see. We'll take first is allele for parent 1, allele of 1. Okay. Next we'll take allele of parent 2. Next we'll see, next one is phenotype of offsprings. Phenotype of offsprings. Next, genotype of offsprings. So first of all, allele for parent 1, if we will take, the blood group is the same in both the parents, that is A blood group. Okay. So what the alleles will come here? Capital IA, here is the capital IA. So what is the phenotype? Means which blood group will come? A. And what are the genotypes? IA. Because this capital I dominates over small I. So blood group is A. What are the genotypes of offsprings? Capital I and small I. Next is, when the both parents are homozygous B blood group, what the alleles will come? Capital IB, capital IB. Okay, homozygous means capital IB, capital IB. Same. Okay, then here the blood group will be B, means phenotype it is, and what is the genotype? IB, IB. This is about the homozygous B blood group. Now here, heterozygous B blood group means one allele is capital IB and another allele is the small I. Okay, how can you see? Capital IB and here small I. So which is the blood group? B here. And what are the genotypes? Capital IB and small I. So when the parents has a different blood group, means one allele of this parent is A, that is A blood group, another is the IB, means B blood group, parent with IA and IB. So what the blood group will come, means phenotype of the offsprings will come, AB blood group. Okay, and here what are the genotypes? IA, IB. Same. Suppose if one parent, this first parent is blood group, is with blood group B, that is IB. Another parent with A blood group. So A, this is the B and this is I. Again, what the phenotype will come? AB blood group. Okay, so what are the genotypes? IA, IB. Here, lastly, suppose the parents with O blood group. Okay, so what are the alleles for O? Is you have to use small I, small I. So this is what your phenotype is, O, the offsprings with O blood group, and here the genotypes are small I, small I. You have to remember this. We have to solve this by genetically. Means here, the two parents are taken. One parent, this is another parent. So these are the blood group of, the genotypes of blood group of the parent 1. These are the genotypes of the blood group of the parent 2. So what the offsprings will produce? Phenotype means the external appearance. Means we have to observe here which type of blood groups are formed. And what are the genotypes of these blood groups. Okay, means the genotype of the offsprings. So you have to remember homozygous. Whenever the condition of the blood group is homozygous A, then you have to use IA, IB. whenever it is heterozygous, we have to write capital I A, we have to take small I because this is the one allele of I. Okay. So already I told you that the gene I has the three allele, that is capital I A, capital I B, and small I. So already you know capital I A and I B are what dominant over the small I. Okay. So this is the recessive and this is the dominant. So this is about the codominance. And I told you what are the genotypes of the ABO blood group. Also we have finished. And then this is what I taken some of the examples how the parental generation blood groups are there and what the blood groups will come in the offspring, the phenotype and the genotype. So this is about codominance. I hope you might have understood. If you are not understanding this concept, please see watch the of my videos. Two, three times, then you will get. If you are not getting the points, you can ask me the questions. Okay. In today's session, we have seen the two concepts. That is, one is the incomplete dominance, and another one is the codominance. As I told you, the question may be asked based on the incomplete dominance. That for 5 marks question will come. Okay. Already I told you. Explain the incomplete dominance question will come for 5 marks. You have to remember. And then next one is this codominance about this, regarding this, the question may be asked for 3 marks or 2 marks. If sometime they will ask the definition with example. So you have to write the definition and you have to mention the example ABO blood group in humans. And then sometime they will ask the genotype of the ABO blood group in humans. Okay, so I told you before this point, I told you totally 6 types of genotypes are formed by the 4 different types of blood groups. Okay, so you have to remember. So this completes your codominance. In next session, next class, we'll see the next point of this chapter, that is chromosomal theory. Until that, stay home. Thank you.